Hey, what's up? It's your girl Dina from Dinas.tv. I am a fitness trainer and lifestyle coach. I've not only transformed my body, but I've transformed many people through my online coaching and through my boot camps. I'm going to be sharing tools with you that are going to transform your body and transform your life. Now is the time that you live the life that you love and love the life that you live. The time is now to make changes. The time is now to grow.
Are you struggling to lose weight? Are you finding yourself eating less and less just so that you can break that scale and finally lose some weight? Or maybe that you heard that you have to eat less calories. Now, in this episode, I'm going to be talking about calories. I'm going to be talking about should you be counting your calories, how much you should be eating, and what happens to your body when you do eat less. Now, for those who don't know what calories is, basically calories is the amount of energy that we get from food, okay? Now, we want to be healthy, right? Now, when you look up the word healthy, what does that exactly mean? When you look up the definition, it says in a good physical or mental condition, right? So if we want to be healthy, we need to have the right energy so that we feel good, so that we can perform 100% at everything that we do. So we wake up feeling energized. We feel energized to actually go to the gym or to actually take that walk outside, to have the energy to perform good at work, to have the energy to be even positive and, you know, feel good and smile and radiant throughout your entire day, right? So in order to be healthy, we need that energy. Now, when you read in magazines or maybe a trainer or someone told you, you got to eat less if you want to lose weight. Now, this is just one aspect of nutrition and weight loss, but you can't just take one little part and neglect everything else. Before I jump into what happens to your body when you eat less, I want you to understand that the different kinds of foods help you for different reasons. You eat carbs for energy. You have your healthy fats in order to balance your hormones and for your brain to function properly. You eat your protein so that your muscles can repair. And this is just very basic, just so you can kind of have an understanding. So that when you are limiting yourself from food and eating less and less every time, you're restricting your body from those nutrients, from those vitamins and minerals, from those macronutrients that your body needs in order to perform, in order for it to do its job properly. I know when someone is struggling to lose weight, their main focus is, what do I have to do? What program do I have to follow? What do I got to eat to lose weight? And I don't want you to lose sight. So when you're restricting yourself from these macronutrients, you're restricting your body from repairing itself. You're restricting your body from growing and being able to perform and do what it's supposed to do. Anything that you put in your mouth is either fighting a disease or feeding into a disease. And when you want to lose weight, you got to be healthy. And when you're in a healthy state, you will start to lose weight. And I know when people are struggling to lose weight, they lose that connection with food. They start to hate food. They look at it as an enemy. And I don't want you to feel like that. I want you to enjoy your meals. I want you to connect with your body, with your being, with every emotion, with every bite that goes into your mouth, to appreciate your health and to appreciate the food that you have in front of you. So I'm going to give you a couple examples so you can truly understand exactly what I'm saying, okay? Now, say for an example, someone is eating 4,000 calories and one day they wake up, they're super motivated and they're like, you know what? That's it. I want to be healthy. I want to transform my body. I want to transform my life. I'm sick and tired of eating this junk food, all this stuff. They're done with it. They're ready now. Okay. So what do? They get a diet plan or they follow someone else's plan or they read whatever, something online. Now, when you start to eat healthier, automatically you're going to be eating less calories because junk food has so much more calories than healthier food options. So when you start to eat chicken breast and salad and vegetables and, you know, sweet potato or whatever, it's not going to, you know, you're going to be able to eat so much more, you know, comparing the same amount of calories. So if you're eating burgers and fries and Snickers and chocolate throughout your day, let's say you're eating 4,000. Now you want to change. You start a clean diet. Now that you started this clean diet, you're probably eating, let's say, 1,700 calories, or let's just say 2,000 to round it up. So now your body adapted to 4,000 for so long. Your body will always try to adapt, okay? We have something in our body, it's a system called homeostasis. And what that means is it's always trying to adapt to whatever you're doing, okay? If you're eating 4,000, this is just one example of the whole system of what it does. But let's just think about calories in food right now. So your body will be like, okay, this person's eating 4,000 calories. I'm going to stick to 4,000. Now it trusted that it's getting 4,000 calories in order to survive. So now all of a sudden you eat 2,000. And on top of that, you're probably working out. So you're burning a couple of hundred extra. So in the beginning, you're going to lose weight. The first month, bam, you lost 10, 20 pounds. You feel amazing. Oh my God, I lost the weight. I feel so good. I'm super motivated. And then what happens? You think that you reach a plateau. You're like, I can't lose weight anymore. I lost these first 20 pounds, but now I can't lose it anymore. What happens? Your body actually, it went into survival mode. It trusted that it was getting 4,000 calories of energy every day. Now all of a sudden it's getting 2,000. All of a sudden on top of that, it's working out. The body freaks out. The body's like, oh man, we're not going to be able to survive like this. We're used to having 4,000 calories. So now let's start shutting down some of the bodily functions, okay? Your metabolism, everything to do with your body's processes, okay? So it starts to shut some of them down in order to preserve energy. And you think, I hit a plateau and now I need to eat less. And I see so many people make that mistake. They keep eating less and less and restricting their food. And all they're doing is slowing down the metabolism. Why? You eat less, you burn less. Always remember that. In the beginning, yes, you will lose weight. Because when you eat junk food, you're retaining so much water. So yeah, you're going to burn a little bit fat, but mainly you're going to be losing a lot of water weight. So then what are you supposed to do? Many habits, many small changes, so that your body can trust you, so that your body can adapt to the process that it's going through. So it's going along the process with you. So it's like, all right, you know, it understands what's happening, okay? So if you're eating 4,000, let's say, you know, you're having a sandwich in the morning with chips, and then you're having McDonald's for lunch, you know, a couple of bites of chocolate throughout your day. Instead of changing everything at once, say, you know what? I'm just going to cut the chocolate out, and I'm going to start working out. Because now you're just cutting out 200 calories, for an example, or 300. You're not drastically changing. A couple of hundred isn't going to, you know, slow down your metabolism. But when you do drastic changes, that's when it happens. And you want your body to understand and go through the process, okay? You say, okay, I'm just going to cut out sugar for now. And instead of eating McDonald's, now later on, you'll start making your burger at home. Instead of eating fries, you start baking your sweet potato. This will not only help your body to adapt to the amount of calories that you're eating, but it will also help you mentally. Because if you change everything at once, you might get overwhelmed. And then if you one day screw up, you might feel, you know, like a failure. And you don't want to feel like that. This is a lifestyle. This is a journey. It's the person that you become across this journey. It's not how fast you get results. Yes, we want to achieve faster results than someone who's maybe making mistakes along the way. And if we can avoid them, that's great. But the person that you become, you want to connect with your food. You want to feel confident. You want to be positive. You don't want to have this negative connection with your body and with food and the way you look at food and everything, because stress will affect you. This negative energy will affect your metabolism. Our thoughts, our emotions, everything that we feel affects our digestive system. It affects how we even burn fat. So I don't want to get into all that right now because I know I can get carried away. So I just want you to realize it's not about eating less, okay? In order to speed up your metabolism and to burn more fat and to have more energy and feel good, we need a good amount of food. So don't be scared about eating. What should you do? You burn that energy through exercise. So instead of eating less, I have my clients eat. I'm like, all right, don't worry, eat. You're eating healthy foods. Eat. Don't be afraid. But go to the gym and use that energy and go beast it, kill it. Do your cardio, do your resistance training, gain that muscle, and use that food to recover, for your muscles to repair, so that you wake up with energy and not fatigue. Oh my God, man, I feel so exhausted. Now If you don't eat and you start working out, your body's going to be even more exhausted. And then what's going to happen? Now you're connecting negative emotions to working out and food because it's not making you feel good. So this is not going to motivate you if this is the connection that you're going to have with food and working out and with your body. So the goal is to exchange with mini habits. Don't worry too much about the numbers, okay? Just make sure you're getting your protein in every meal. Make sure that you're getting, you know, enough healthy carbs in your body so that you get that energy. You feel like your energy is down? Increase those carbs. Don't be afraid. Make sure you're getting those healthy fats, those almonds and walnuts, so that you can feel good and so that your brain can function properly. Remember, all of this food is what's going to make your body healthy, feel good, give you that energy so that you can wake up every day and ready to just beast it and attack each and every one of your goals. Now, let's say, for an example, you're listening to this podcast and you're like, shit, man, I've been making this mistake. I've been eating less and less, and now I'm eating 900 or 1,000 calories. What do? You don't now jump into 3,000. Now you slowly, gradually increase it. So if you're having 1,000 every couple of days, increase it by 100. And don't worry about the numbers that you have to calculate it now. You increase it with the food. So say, for an example, you have a fruit, or you add a little bit more rice in there, or you add more potato little by little. So you don't really have to sit there and try to figure out numbers and calculating and doing the math yourself. You just slowly start adding the food into there. And if you feel like maybe you're not getting much of an appetite, go work out. Go work out harder. Maybe you're not burning enough energy. Maybe you're not giving enough in the gym and you feel like you are, but you're not really. Because if you are, trust me, your body's going to want that energy in order to recover. So you start to slowly increase it until you get to an amount where you feel good. You're like, all right, I feel good like this. You know, I feel like this is enough food for me to eat. My body's recovering. I'm waking up. I feel amazing. This is the ultimate goal, is to be able to eat, still burn, and this is how you're going to get the body that you want on top of that. There's no way of you eating so little that your muscles are going to grow, the cellulite's going to go, your body's going to get toned. It's not. In order for your body to transform, you need to build a little bit of muscle. Building muscle is what's going to help you burn more energy throughout the day. Building muscle is what's going to help you give you that lean, toned look and that six pack because you're burning more. And when you build muscle, your skin gets tighter. And when you build more muscle, you lose that cellulite. All right. So it's all connected to each other. And I'm not talking about big bodybuilding muscle. I'm talking about, you know, minimal muscle, just doing resistance training. But your muscles won't grow if you're not feeding it the right food. That's the thing. You could be going and doing all these classes and, you know, joining these boot camp classes or body pump or all that. But you're eating so little, your body is not able to repair and grow. All right, I don't want to talk your ear out. I just wanted to make it very clear for you. So keep in mind, you know what? I'm going to get that food. I'm going to get that energy that my body needs. I'm just going to burn it when I exercise. So the body knows that it's getting that energy. Yeah, it knows it's burning it, but it knows that it's getting it. And then the body will trust you and it will start releasing that fat. And slowly your metabolism will start to speed up little by little. And then you'll become like those people who eat so much and don't gain weight. If you have any questions, don't feel shy. You know, share anything that you're struggling with, any questions that you have. I'm doing these episodes for you because I want to help you, because I know that if you have this information and that if you apply it, you can transform your body and you can transform your life. So feel free to leave a comment below, shoot me a message on Instagram, on Facebook, send me an email, whatever is good for you. I really want to hear what you're going through, and I'm excited to, you know, see the progress in your journey and the progress in your life to living a healthier lifestyle and being your best self. I hope you enjoyed my podcast. If you have any questions, just shoot me a message or leave me a comment below. If you want to check out my workout routines, you can find me on all social media platforms at Dina's TV, or you can go straight to my website at dinas.tv. I also created a private Facebook group where I will be uploading videos and I will also be live streaming so that we can engage with each other and you can ask me questions. All you have to do is type in transform your body and transform your life to find it on Facebook.
Make sure to subscribe. And if you found this podcast to be helpful, please leave me a review. It helps the podcast to reach more people. I also check each and everyone's comment. Thank you so much for tuning in. Until the next episode, stay strong, stay healthy, and always stay happy.